Hello YouTube viewers, welcome to my show Science Thursday. Today in episode number 4, we're gonna look at water as a fuel, and this is gonna be an episode of that pseudoscience because it's flat out not possible. So let's dive into it, understand this pseudoscience. So how it came to be, how this idea came to be. Water is made out of hydrogen and oxygen, H2O, and hydrogen can be used as fuel. Heck, it's a rocket fuel for all intents and purposes. And some dumb people have really bad understanding of energy, how energy works. And do not feel bad, because this sort of scam has been going on for decades. And like, this is China, this is Gujarat, this is another recently that came to my Facebook feed, and suffice to say, I am shocked at how many people fall for it. So let's dive into it more. So how do they work? Like, because they do work, I mean, like, news channel do show them working, so how the heck they are working? All you have to understand, there are only two probable way that they are working. First way is electrolysis, where they are using electricity to split hydrogen and oxygen. Very common pattern, we do it in labs, nothing fancy or nothing magical about it. And then there is a second reaction where we introduce a chemical reaction. In an earlier system we were using electricity, in this system we use some sort of chemical element like calcium carbide. Now here's the deal, if you are using electrolysis, use that energy, like electrolysis in terms of the battery you have for the electrical energy, just use that battery to run the motor, it will be much more efficient. It's very simple, and the source of the electricity becomes the source, not water you are using for electrolysis. In that scenario, water acts as a battery, a very inefficient one, but a battery, not a source. It's like you are calling a rechargeable car. It's not that it's running on magic, it's running on coal power, it's running on hydro power, it may be running on wind power, but it's not running on its own, it's taking power from those sources. So the electrolysis route is flat out inefficient. Then we come to the second part, which can almost fool anyone. It's chemical reaction. Now to understand this well and understand it permanently, you have to think of it this way. Your car generally has an air intake. Does that mean your car is air runs on air? No. That's a simple thing. The element that you are using, like in this example I'm giving calcium carbide, that is the element that's running your, that's your fuel source, and it's creating gases. Sometimes it gives hydrogen. It's generally used in oxygen torch, the torch that you use to cut. So suffice to say, the fuel source is not water. Water is just acting as a medium. Same way water, air acts as a medium for your internal combustion engine. It provides the oxygen. Water is providing it with the material. So you are using calcium carbide for that sort of thing. So please, if you see electrolysis, just realize that flat out using electricity direct is much better. And if you find something that does not use electricity, has some hydrogen generator and things like that, they are generally using some chemistry for this purpose. But problem is, then you are not running on water. Now let's dive more into it. So why not? Like, you know, water is a byproduct of hydrogen plus oxygen combustion. What does that mean? Think of it this way. You take coal, you burn it, you get ash. Now try reburning that ash. It's not gonna burn. It's already done. It's already spent. So same way, CO2 is what happens when you burn carbon in the presence of oxygen. CO2 is the byproduct. This is what comes out of your exhaust pipe in your car, bike or whatever. You can't burn it, it's already burnt. Like, you know, the reaction is already done. It's an exothermic reaction. Basically, when these two join, they give off energy. But here's the deal, once they are joined, they no longer have that energy. They already given it out, it's done. So this is a schematic of a hydrogen car, which works. This is completely true, but they are very honest about it. It's hydrogen car. You have to give hydrogen to it. Hydrogen goes into fuel cell. Fuel cell takes oxygen from the environment, and based on that, you get electricity and water as an exhaust or byproduct. So water, in terms of like hydrogen and oxygen, already combined, already have given out. That's why it's water. Water puts out fires. You can't burn water practically. And there are some, as already mentioned, there are chemical process, there is electrolysis. Heck, you increase the temperature to 3000 degrees Celsius, water is gonna break. Thermolysis is classified. But here's the deal, where are you getting the energy to make that? So suffice to say, as you can see the molecule of that carbon dioxide, it's burnt. Carbon dioxide is burnt. Same with water, it's already burnt. The sole reason we don't capture it so well is that we don't think of water as an exhaust, but it is exhaust. Like, your body is done with it. Your life form is done with it. Your car is done with it. It's the final product. It's like the final ash. You can't reburn it. I mean, like, you can do, but you have to import energy, and at that point might as well directly run that energy. So that's why it's not possible. Now, some of you might say, hey, how the heck plants work? It has the deal. Plants do take carbon dioxide, but they don't use that carbon dioxide as a fuel source. They use sunlight as fuel source. So it's solar powered. They are taking carbon dioxide, so they can take the carbon from carbon dioxide and build themselves. That's why wood is mostly carbon. They are absorbing carbon from the atmosphere, and to break carbon dioxide, they are using sunlight. That's all there is. You can't use carbon dioxide or water as an energy source. They can act as a battery, like, you know, you split hydrogen from oxygen and, you know, make electrolysis. You stored your electrical energy in sense, now you have hydrogen, you can run through fuel cell and get the power back. But it's not an energy source. It's not like kerosene, it's not like jet fuel, it's not like even pure hydrogen. Basically, it's already burnt. So suffice to say, please be mindful, it cannot be done. On chemical level, it cannot be done. So then comes to the fact that why so much attention to it? Like, and I already mentioned, like, this one is very old. This scam artist did that shit in 1990s. So first you have to understand, this is very hipster. It's like, yo man, I'm gonna solve the world problem. It feels very hipsterish, like childish. And then you have to understand, like, conspiracy theory, they love this. It's like, you know, there was this inventor who figured out how to run cars on water, and then petrol company killed them. You know, it has that juicy factor to it. And, you know, it gets, like, people go into full conspiracy. I'm like, dude, you can do it at your home. Figure that shit out, okay? And then the most attractive part of it, the reason why news channels show it, it's one ring to rule them all. It's like, you have this, you have solved every single problem. It's like everything. It's like all the hipsters, all the conspiracy theory, all the peace, loving earth, peace, unity, and all that shit, it's all solved. But the sole reason we come down to is, like, science is hard. It's difficult to understand. So at the end of this, all I want you to understand is that water is a byproduct. To make it usable, again, you have to put in the energy. Now, if you're putting in the energy, I'm just saying, you are recharging it. Basically, you are using it as a battery. So directly use the battery. It's much more efficient. So that was my video. I hope you like this presentation. Thanks you for watching, and I hope you liked it or learned from it. If in that case, please like. If you didn't, dislike, leave a comment, and subscribe. And if you are free, press the bell icon. Thanks for watching.